Okay, very good morning to everyone. Let's discuss about thyroid and anti-thyroid agents. So initially we will talk about thyroid hormones, that is particularly T3 and T4 used for the treatment of depressive disorder. Okay, so triiodothyronine is used to treat Wilson's syndrome and also to treat diabetes and epilepsy. Okay. So here is a common structural setup you can observe here. Two aromatic rings are there. X in between X is shown. And to the A ring, aromatic ring, there is a side chain. And to the B, that aromatic ring, there is a hydroxyl moiety. Okay. The two phenyl rings must be connected by the ether. Okay. That means oxygen. Or thioether. That means sulfur. Or methylene bridge. Methylene bridge means CH2. Means this X that can be O, S or CH2 in order to maintain the activity. A carbonyl group must be present in the aliphatic side chain. Suppose this is aliphatic side chain. So that chain must possess a carbonyl functional group C double bond O. Halogen or methyl substituent may be placed at 3' and 5' positions. See, that means halogen means iodine, or that 3' and 5' position. To the 3' and 5' position, halogen or methyl substituent may be placed, okay, for the activity. The 3' monosubstituted analogs are more active. 3' substituted analogs are more active than as compared with the 3' and 5' disubstituted compounds. Which one is active? Monosubstituted. Okay, more active. For maximal activity, position 4' should be occupied by hydroxyl group. Okay, suppose maximal activity is we expect, then in that case, this para position must be occupied with the OH group. Okay, the bulky and lipophilic group at 3' position enhance the activity. Okay, suppose there is a bulky group, lipophilic group at 3' position, that will enhance the activity. The 3' substituent should be distal and the S' substituent should be proximal to the side chain bearing ring in order to maintain the hormone molecule in the active conformation. Okay, active conformation, how this can be obtained? That should be 3' substituent, that should be distal, okay, and should be proximal to the side chain. That 5' substituent, that should be proximal, okay, to the side chain, bearing chain, in order to maintain the active conformation. Let's discuss now the structures. I will take that annotator so that it becomes little bit easy to show the position where I am discussing, what portion I am discussing. So see, this is a thyronine. Okay, thyronine. Now you already know what is amino acid. You must be capturing this as a amino acid. Okay, carbon having attachment of NH2 and carbon having attachment of COH. That means you can guess that this is amino acid. Okay, now CH3 is attached. That means this is, we call it as a alanine. And phenyl group is also attached. That means it is a phenylalanine. Okay, now the half portion of that structure is clear to you. This one is the phenylalanine. Now observe that O group, yes, in the that X we shown, that can be O, okay, in case of thyronine T3, T4, so that is a O, okay. Now aromatic ring, 3' substituent, that should be distal, and 5' substituent, that should be proximal to achieve the active conformation, and para position, that should possess a hydroxyl group. That means now you can easily feel that This thyronin, structure of thyronin is not at all difficult. Now observe the structure for T3. How that structure you can draw? OH aromatic ring at this iodine moiety, iodine molecule, iodine, then oxygen, then two iodine molecules at this and this position, and then the setup of alanine. You can draw in this way also. If you don't want to draw in such way, you can choose this pattern of writing, this pattern of drawing the structures. This part and this part, it's same. Okay, that is a phenylalanine, setup of phenylalanine. Okay, now observe this thyroxine structure. What is difference between this structure and this structure? There is a simple difference of iodine only. You can observe OH group at the para position. At 3-5 position, there is iodine, then oxygen as a X, then again aromatic ring having iodine, okay, and that phenylalanine, setup of phenylalanine. You can draw in such way if you prefer that, okay. Now see this next part. Again, I will take that annotator so that it will be easy to explain the things. So, biosynthesis of thyroid hormone, right? Which are the thyroid important thyroid hormones? As you know, that are T3 and T4. Okay. So, steps involved in the biosynthesis of thyroid hormone that are iodine uptake, oxidation and iodination, coupling, storage and release, peripheral conversion of T3 and T4. Means, if you observe this carefully, you will find that iodination, that is a major step for the biosynthesis of thyroid hormones. Now, I will again take that annotator for simplifying the... Wait for a while. So, let us discuss about that biosynthesis of thyroid hormone, that is T3 and T4. Initial, what is the precursor? What you will take? You will take tyrosine. You know that tyrosine means it's a hydroxyl group attached to the para position of phenylalanine, right? So, upon iodination, what will happen? Iodine will get attached near to the hydroxyl group, okay? The carbon which is nearer to the hydroxyl group, or we can say to the meta position. Tyrosine, upon iodination, it will get converted into I substituted at the meta position. What we will call to this structure? We will call it as a monoiodotyrosine. Again, further iodination of that monoiodotyrosine, it will get converted into 3,5-diiodotyrosine. Okay. Again, further iodination, it will form the T3. That is, you can observe here structure of T3. Already you know that structure. Para position, hydroxyl group, aromatic ring, iodine, oxygen as a bridge, right? Oxygen as a bridge, then aromatic ring, II, okay? And this is setup of alanine, or we can say phenylalanine. And upon further iodination, what we will get? We will get the thyroxine. Wait a minute, again I have to choose that annotator. Okay, now upon T3, upon iodination, again it will add one of the iodine and it will form a thyroxine, that is T4. Very easy structure, that hydroxyl group at the para position, aromatic ring having iodine and iodine, then oxygen as a bridge, then again aromatic ring having iodine, and this is a setup of alanine. Very easy. So this is very simple biosynthesis for thyroid hormones T3 and T4. Okay. Now let us talk about mechanism of action. The T3 and T4 binds to nuclear receptors. Thyroid receptors T3 and T4 are very lipophilic and able to pass through phospholipid bilayers of target cells. The lipophilicity of T3 and T4 require their binding to the protein carrier, thyroid binding protein, thyroxine binding globulins, thyroxine binding prealbumins, and albumin for the transport in the blood. The thyroid receptor binds to response element in gene promoters, thus enabling them to activate or inhibit gene transcription. Means you can catch this keyword for the MCQ point of view, that will inhibit the gene transcription. T3 binds to ligand binding domain of thyroid receptors. The sensitivity of the tissue to the T3 is modulated through the thyroid receptors. So always, whenever you study, know that time, try to catch the keywords or key sentences or key half sentences. Okay, here I will pause a while and we will talk about anti-thyroid drugs. Okay, now you got a little idea about thyroxine, thyronin, T3, T4, yes, you got that idea. It's about its mechanism of action, what it inhibits, that you got, right? Now let us talk about anti-thyroid drugs. Anti-thyroid drugs, they inhibit hormone synthesis, okay? Which are the examples that inhibit the hormone synthesis? Which hormone synthesis? T3 and T4, like that, thyroid hormone synthesis inhibit. Which drugs inhibit that thyroid hormone synthesis? So propylthiouracil, methimazole, carbimazole, thiouria, okay, and 2-thiouracil. These are the examples. Now this is the mechanism of these anti-thyroid drugs. Means for propylthiouracil, which mechanism you have? That inhibit hormone synthesis. Particularly, these are the anti-thyroid drugs. So inhibit iodide trapping. In that we have example nitrates, perchlorates, and thiocyanates. Inhibit hormone release. For that we have example iodine, iodide of Na and K, organic iodide. Okay, and destroy thyroid tissue. In that we have example radioactive iodine, that I-131, I-125, okay, and I-123. And miscellaneous antithyroid agents, we have example carbetamide and resorcinol. Okay, now let us talk about the definition for antithyroid agent. It is the hormone antagonist, okay, it is hormone antagonist acting upon thyroid hormones. Very easy, name itself reflects that it is anti-thyroid. That means an anti-thyroid agent is a hormone antagonist acting upon thyroid hormones, or simply you can say that thyroid hormone antagonist is equal to anti-thyroid agent. The main anti-thyroid drugs are carbimazole. Just focus on these one: carbimazole, methimazole, and propylthiouracil. So that can be abbreviated as a PTU. A less common antithyroid agent is a potassium perchlorate. Okay, got this? Now let us talk about the structures given for antithyroid agents. So here you will just see that inhibit hormone synthesis, in that we have propylthiouracil. So observe this structure. What this structure is? This is basically, we can say that it is a which ring? Which ring is there in this? Pyrimidine. IUPAC is a very nice way to get this structure easily. So pyrimidine 4-one is there. right? Pyrimidine 4-ONE is there. At least remember that. And propyl moiety is attached here, okay? That means, and why it is called as thiouracil? Because this sulfur group is attached. Therefore, that word thio is there. So it is very easy structure. You will draw pyrimidine. You will draw double bond S. You will draw double bond O. You will add only one double bond in a ring and you will attach a propyl group at the sixth position. So this is very easy structure for propyl thiouracil that inhibits the thyroid hormone synthesis, one of the antithyroid agent. Propyl thiouracil is used to treat hyperthyroidism. Okay, so for what purpose it is used? To treat the hyperthyroidism, propyl thiouracil. And side effects of these are stomach upset, nausea, vomiting, muscle pain and dizziness. Mechanism of action of propyl thiouracil, it inhibits the production of new thyroid hormone. Okay, remember this one, inhibits the production of new thyroid hormone in the thyroid gland. म्हणजे थायरॉइड ग्लँडमध्ये नवीन हार्मोनचं प्रोडक्शन इनहिबिट केलं जातं. इट ॲक्ट्स बाय इनहिबिटिंग द एन्झाइम थायरॉइड पेरॉक्सिडेज. व्हेनेवर वी स्टडी दिज मेकॅनिझम ऑफ ॲक्शन, नो दॅट नेम ऑफ एन्झाइम इज व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट. मीन्स फॉर MCQ यू कॅन फोकस ऑन दॅट एन्झाइम थायरॉइड पेरॉक्सिडेज, विच युजली फंक्शन्स टू कन्वर्ट आयोडाईड टू आयोडीन मॉलिक्यूल. What is the function of thyroid peroxidase? That converts iodide to a iodine molecule and incorporate the iodine molecule into amino acid tyrosine. Okay. Now let us see very very simple structure, and that is a methimazole. Meth means methyl, and me means methyl. Thi means sulfur. So remember this mercaptan group. SH group, that is a thi group or mercaptan group. And mazole, you will remember that this is a imidazole. Okay, so this is structure for methimazole. It is used to treat hyperthyroidism, a condition that occurs when the thyroid gland produce a too much of thyroid hormone. Thyroid hormone excess झालं तर त्या कंडिशनला काय म्हणतात? हायपरथायरॉइडिझम. म्हणजे हे जे प्रोपिल थायोयुरासिल आहे, प्रोपिल थायोयुरासिल झालं, मिथिमॅझोल झालं, कशाच्या ट्रीटमेंटमध्ये यूज होतो आहे त्याचा? हायपरथायरॉइडिझम. ओके, नाउ लेट अस सी दिस आयुपीएसी नेम. 3-methyl-1-hydrogen-imidazole 2-thione. Okay, forget about that IUPC. You will check that IUPC again. So this is the structure, which is very very easy. And methimazole used for the treatment of hyperthyroidism. Remember that its side effects are hair loss, aplastic anemia, headache, nausea and polyarthritis. Okay, now mechanism of action, it interferes with the step that causes iodination of the thyroid residues to thyroglobulin, mediated by enzyme thyroid peroxidase. See again, which enzyme is very very important in case of mechanism of action? That inhibition of which enzyme? That thyroid peroxidase, thus preventing the synthesis of thyroxine, that is T4, and triiodothyronine, that is T3. So this is very very nice discussion about thyroid and antithyroid agents. Definitely you will get very nice information from this PDF, and you will study genuinely for that. Thank you very much.